Hi, everybody. It's Sister Nadine. It's Sunday, May 17th, and I have another lesson for you. Our lesson today is about Daniel, and the title of our lesson is Not Your Average Cat. You're going to find out what that means as the story goes along. But you know what time it is. It's time to get your wigglies out, and I hope that you enjoy this time together. Remember, God loves you and I love you. So we're going to sing three songs, and I think you know them already, and I hope that you enjoy getting your wigglies out.
Worthy of all Cause I've got stream with me, I'll praise. I've got all the speed, I'll praise. I praise God. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God.
Did you enjoy that, children? God is great, and He is good, and He is wonderful. And He is powerful, and we're going to learn that God is always with us, no matter what. And now it's time to talk to God. So I need you guys to close your eyes and bow your heads and try to think about God right now. Dear God and Heavenly Father, thank you for being present, even though we can't see you. Thank you for allowing us to talk to you through prayer. Help me, Lord, to teach the lesson that you would want the children to learn and to help them understand what you want them to know. Help us to remember that you are always with us. In Jesus' name, amen. So we're going to learn a really good lesson today. And our lesson aim or theme is that God is amazingly big and He is always present and faithful to help us. Our lesson continues talking about Daniel. Now, I'll give you a little bit of background. You know, Daniel and his friends were taken from their homeland to Babylon. And Daniel and his friends were given jobs in the government. And many years had gone by, and Cyrus, the emperor of the great Medo-Persian Empire, conquered the Babylonian Empire. And he appointed a man named Darius as the new king of Babylon. Daniel was living in Babylon during this time. Each day, Daniel would pray to God, facing towards Jerusalem, to remember his own homeland. King Darius wanted to appoint the best men to be his new government leaders. He noticed a Jewish man named Daniel. Daniel was an awfully hard worker. He was trustworthy, and he never cheated anyone. Daniel always acted responsibly. King Darius appointed Daniel as a special helper to the king. Daniel worked extremely hard for the king. He was never lazy. He always tried to do his best. One of the reasons Daniel did such a good job was that he knew that God would want him to work with all his heart. Soon, Daniel was doing such a good job that King Darius decided to make him ruler over all the other helpers in the kingdom. King Darius liked Daniel, but the king's other helpers did not. They thought the king favored Daniel over them. They wanted Daniel to get in trouble. They kept trying to find Daniel doing something wrong so they could tell King Darius, but they could never see Daniel doing anything wrong. Daniel always worked hard. He loved God, and he prayed to God. Finally, the king's helpers came up with a plan to get rid of Daniel. If they could get the king to make a new law about praying to God, then they could trap Daniel. The helpers went to King Darius and gave him lots of compliments. They told him he was a good king and that he was like a god. They said that all the other king's helpers wanted the king to make a new law. This wasn't true because only a few of the king's helpers wanted the king to make a new law. They said that the law should say that no one would be allowed to pray to any god for 1 month. They could only pray to King Darius. If anyone disobeyed the law, then they should be thrown into a pit of lions. King Darius liked this idea. He felt especially important. He wrote the law down and signed it. Since the king signed it, everyone had to obey it. It was the law of the Medes and Persians. Once a king signed a law, it could not be changed. The king couldn't even change it. When Daniel heard about the new law, he was sad. He had always tried to do his best to serve the king, but he knew that he could not pray to King Darius. That would be wrong. He could only ever pray to the one true God. Usually Daniel prayed to the Lord 3 times each day. He decided to keep praying like he always did. But this time the king's other helpers were ready. They had been watching Daniel and they knew when he prayed. They went straight to the king and told him about it. King Darius was incredibly sad. Now he knew that his helpers had tricked him, but he could not change the law. He ordered Daniel to be thrown into the lion's den. But before he put Daniel inside, he said to Daniel, "May your God, whom you continually serve, rescue you." Daniel must have been very frightened when he was put with the lions. The lions could eat him up. Then it got very dark. It got dark because a stone was rolled over the entrance of the den, and a seal was put on the stone, and wax melted into it, and the king pressed his ring into the wax to form a seal. When anyone looked at the seal, they would know that no one could move the stone and help Daniel. During the night, the king could not eat or sleep. He kept thinking about his helper, Daniel. Early the next morning, the king rushed to the lion's den. When he got near to the entrance, he yelled out to Daniel, "Daniel, was your God able to save you?" Then the king heard Daniel's voice. He was alive. Daniel said, "During the night, the Lord sent an angel to come and to shut the lion's mouth. It's a miracle. I'm alive." When Daniel was taken out of the den, there was not one scratch on him. The king was so happy that Daniel was alive. He was not happy, however, at his other helpers. He did not like it that they had tried to trick him. He ordered all the bad helpers and their families to be thrown into the lion's den. Then King Darius ordered that everyone must show respect to Daniel's God. He is a living God, and he will rule forever. His kingdom will never be destroyed, and his power will never come to an end. He rescues and performs miracles. He saved Daniel from being killed by the lions. All right. I hope you enjoyed that story. Now we're going to find out if you can answer these questions. What did you learn from Daniel chapter 6, verses 1 through 28? Why did King Darius trust Daniel? Did you say because Daniel was a hard worker and did his best? What did Daniel do 3 times every day? Did you say prayed to God? What kind of law did the king's other helpers get the King Darius to write? Did you say if anyone in the kingdom prays to anyone other than the king for a month, they would be thrown into the lion's den? Why did Daniel not die in the lion's den? God sent an angel to shut the lion's mouth. What did the king do to the other helpers? Did you say he threw them and their families in the lion's den? What did the king order the people to do? Did you say that everyone must show respect to Daniel's God? I hope you got these answers right. I hope that you remember that God watches over his people, and that he is always with us, even when we don't feel like he's here. Now we're going to do an activity related to our lesson. We have a couple of them. There is a printout that parents, you can do for the kids. And what they need to do is find and circle the 10 differences in the pictures. What is different between the first and the second picture? The next thing is another craft you can do, and I titled it, Let's Make a Lion. You can see my craft. You can make it however you like. I curled my construction paper strips because I thought it made it kind of fun. But again, you can make it however you like. And the instructions are in the handouts. Basically, there is what you'll need as far as the craft supplies and the steps, and along with a template to make the lion's face. I hope you have fun doing that. Our scripture today is found in Daniel, chapter 6, verse 26. Sorry about that. For he is the living God, and he endures forever. His kingdom will not be destroyed, and his dominions will never end. And I love that picture of that powerful lion, because Jesus is the lion from the tribe of Judah. And that's what that reminds me of. Now, for those of you that are able to write well, there is another handout that you can print out that allows you to practice writing the words to the scripture and filling in the blanks. And I hope you have a chance to do that. But if you don't, you can still practice saying the memory verse at least 5 times. And I do want you to try to do it without help. This week, your home activity, I want you to be a worker like Daniel was for God. Everything Daniel did, he did because he wanted to please God, so he did his very best. So I encourage you to be a worker for God by helping others. Maybe you can help with extra chores, or maybe you can help do something nice for a neighbor. But I want you to remember that God is always with you and is faithful to help you when you are being obedient to him. Hi, guys. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. And I hope you'll do the crafts. Again, I do miss you, and I wish we could be together. You know that I love you, and that Jesus loves you, and that he is with us all the time. And we just need to believe and trust him and do our best to obey him. Again, have a great week. I love you, and we'll talk soon.